North Kitsap Baptist Church Sunday School. We're so glad you could come this morning. We're going to continue on our stories in Genesis. So go get your Bible. Go get it right now and turn to the pictures that have Abraham and Isaac in it. Well, look what I brought today. I brought my shovel. Do you have a shovel? Maybe your mom or your dad have a shovel. What do you do with your shovel? What do you dig with a shovel? Well, today we're going to hear about Isaac and his helpers digging. Do you like to dig? It's a fun thing to do. Well, in Bible times, they had shovels that maybe didn't look quite like this, but they were important. Well, Isaac was a grown-up, and he had lots of sheep and goats and camels, and they needed water. So one of the things they would do is go out and dig a big hole. And they would dig and dig and dig until they got to where there was water. And we call a hole that you've dug to water a well. And it probably was hard and hot work. But you know what? They got the well dug and had water. And then all of a sudden the neighbors came running over. They were angry and upset. They're like, "This is our water. You go away. We want this water." Because water was hard to find where they lived, and they needed it for all their animals. Well, Isaac didn't want to fight, so he told his helpers to just go away and leave the well for the neighbors. So guess what they did? They went out and they dug and dug and dug, and whew, that was hard work. And they dug a new well and had water for their animals. And you know what happened again? Here come the neighbors. "You leave that well for us. We need it for our animals." And Isaac didn't want to argue again. He told his helpers, "Just leave the well. Let the neighbors have it." Well, Isaac would spend time at night praying to God. And one night, God spoke to Isaac. He said, "Don't be afraid, Isaac. I will always be with you. I will take good care of you." And Isaac thanked God for taking care of him and being with him. And it wasn't long before, guess what? Here came Isaac's neighbors again. Oh, do they still want to argue and fight? Isaac must have wondered, why have they come here? He said, "You guys have not been kind to me, and you sent us away." But they said, "Isaac, we know God is with you, and we don't want to argue with you anymore. We know God has good things for you, blessings, and we want to be your friends." Well, oh, Isaac must have been so glad to hear that. So he invited everyone to stay and have a big feast and celebrate being friends. And they promised to never argue again. Well, Isaac did something that was hard. He showed kindness to people who were not being kind to him. You know, the Bible says in Matthew 22:39, "Love your neighbor." And we can choose to be kind too, even when it's hard because someone isn't necessarily being nice to us. God still wants us to try our best to be kind. Maybe they want to use the swing an extra long time at the playground. And we want to swing, but you can let them keep swinging. Or maybe you're playing in the sandbox with your shovel and they want to use it. You could let them have a turn. Maybe they don't use kind words, but that's okay. You can still be kind because God says, love your neighbor. Well, we'll hope to see you again next week. Remember to be kind this week, and we'll see you here next Sunday morning.